It's December, that time of the year when everyone meets family. I have a quick question for you guys. How much thought do you put into the photos and videos that you share on your WhatsApp family groups? Do you just take random pictures and videos and put it up, or do you think about what story is this going to tell? Because the last thing that you want is to send 20 videos to a group where people is taking forever to download it and they're not going to watch anyway. I don't know about you, but for me, I share almost all the important things that happen in my life with my family on the WhatsApp group. I obviously prefer talking to them on video, but then when I can't do that or just for documentation reasons, I just send it on documentation. That sounds so... I mean, to go back to a day when something important happened. The day when I was leaving India to come to France, I took pictures and short videos and I put it there. When my sister got her new car, for example, she put up a video there. It's really windy over here. I think we should walk back. So, as I was saying, since we put up all our important stuff on WhatsApp, should really think about who's watching it and is it going to be easy for them to watch this video. I'm going to share with you guys this way that I discovered to share videos on the WhatsApp group to make sure that anyone can download it with any internet that they have. Whether they have the worst Wi-Fi connection or a really slow internet connection, they can download these videos in seconds. Let's say you've already shot this video and you want to send it via WhatsApp. In the conversation, hit that small camera icon in the right bottom corner. Here you can either capture now or just swipe up and attach something that you've already captured. Once you've chosen the video that you want to send over, in the top you can see that there is a little timeline. Over here on the left, it also tells you what is the weight of the video that you're sending. So when you adjust the timeline, bring it to less than 6 seconds and you'll see a GIF option that pops up over here in the right. When you hit this GIF option, you'll notice that it jumped from a couple of megabytes to a few hundred kilobytes, which is much smaller. Once you've chosen this, feel free to move the 6-second window to that important part and hit send. Now what will happen is whoever's downloading this video can get it instantly. It'll download in no time and it'll remain there for documentation purposes. I can't really find of another word to plug in which sounds less formal. I just mean to have all those memories in one conversation where people can react to. For example, when I got my work permit in France, it took a while, but when it arrived, I shared it over here. And now when I search work permit in my conversations, I can go back to the day when it happened. And I like to maintain these conversations, at least with my really close friends and with my family. Those are the advantages of this GIF option, but then there are also the obvious disadvantages, right? There's no audio, the quality is really poor. But then I like this option because people can see it instantaneously. They don't have to wait. It takes as much as time as downloading a photo and they can watch that quick 6-second video. When there are interesting moments like driving your first car or jumping into a beautiful pool in slow-mo, you can still send those shots over here. And if your family really wants to see the good content stuff, you can share with them your Google Photos or your iCloud files or Dropbox if that's what you prefer. But let's be real, how much time do we take to actually put these things on this good quality sharing options and we actually share them? We don't. So in the quickness of what you do in your life, maybe all you have is those couple of minutes. So pull it up and send it across. If you guys use a non-device based storage app, even I don't know what that means. What I mean is if this data is not stored on your phone, something like Facebook or Instagram, then it stays on Facebook or Instagram and they can come back and watch it. But when it's on WhatsApp, if it's lost in the conversation and they didn't download it, they can't go back to it. And if they wait for a couple of months, WhatsApp deletes it from their servers and they can't download it back unless you send it to them. So why not send them something that they'll actually watch? I've received some of these videos, you know, of dance performances where they've recorded videos for a really long time and then they've sent 20-30 videos on end, which are really heavy, and I'm not going to download each one of them to see where the good stuff is. why don't we curate it for our family? A quick 6-second shot or a really important list of pictures. That's been it for this video, guys. I hope that was helpful. I'll talk about sharing good quality videos and photos using Facebook private albums or Google Photos, iCloud or Dropbox, because these are the really popular tools available today and they work really well. But for really quick share, I use WhatsApp too and I really like this feature. Anyways, that's been it for this video, guys. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you're having an awesome time with your family. Take care of yourselves and keep learning.